Hey, this is Ben, and I wanted to talk to you about leasing. To lease or not to lease? That's the question, right? So what is a lease? And I'm going to do this really quickly for you so you understand. A lease is just another form of financing, okay? It's just another form of financing. Typically, a lease allows for easier credit approval because the finance company, which we'll call the lessor, can use your business as the borrower name and only review your personal credit to make sure you don't owe, you know, $11 million and that you're delinquent on it, okay? An equipment lease, which is the type of leasing we do for these mobile food kitchens, hot dog carts, and specifically the Pig Roaster Pro, allows you to make payments over a predetermined period and own the equipment afterwards. So it's not one of those leases like a car lease where you lease it and then you turn it in afterwards. You actually own the equipment. So it's kind of like a normal financing deal, but with less requirements to get in and less strict requirements on credit. The other thing is equipment leases allow the borrower, you, the lessee, to write off 100% of your payments instead of just the interest. Okay? So in a typical lease, you can only write off your interest as an expense if you have a business, but you can't write off your payments. Well, in an equipment lease, because equipment leases are for businesses, you can write off the entire amount, so 100%. So how much will all this cost you? Okay, let's take the Pig Roaster Pro at $89.90, okay? Just for an example, okay? A lease would run you about $250 a month, and I'm going to guesstimate about 48 months because the lease company has to make money because they're taking the risk and upfronting the money to purchase the equipment in which you are leasing, right? So you're talking a total of about $12,000, whole lot of money to spend on a lease. I get it. I know, because you're going, oh my gosh, it started at $9,000 and now I got to pay $3,000 more. Well, sometimes depending on credit types and depending on the lease company, you could pay double the amount. Look at a home mortgage. You pay three times roughly, okay, 2.5 to 3 times what your original purchase price was by the time you're done on a 30-year mortgage. So I'm giving you an example here, and I want to show you how this plays out. Yet vendors rent hot dog carts and mobile kitchens, okay, for 50 to 150 daily, okay? Now I want you to follow me there. I've got vendors who rent out carts to other vendors for 50 to 150 daily, depending on what it includes. Like, does it include the license and a location, that kind of stuff. I used to do this and rented out actually over 20 carts every month. So you can imagine the kind of money you can make there. But I'm putting this into perspective for you. Because I just said a lease would be about $250 a month, right? And here this is about $1,500 a month. Now, based on the averages for the Roasting Nomad Tribe doing 3 pig gigs a week times 4 weeks a month, you'd do about 12 gigs a month. Now, divide $250, your payment, by 12 gigs. That's $21 per gig, or the same as $21 per day used, okay? Which isn't bad, is it? You're not $12 per day, because that'd be like $600 a month, okay? So it's $12 per day, or $21 per day used. Cheap. You've used it 12 times, 12 times 21, roughly $250. Now, you do more gigs in a month, and your average daily, you can divide by more than 12 now. You can divide $250, your payment, by more than 12. So if you're doing 14 or 16 or 18, you know, or you're crazy like Jason, you know, and do 5 to 6 a week, so you're talking 4 times 6, 24 into 250, that's $10 a day or $10 a gig, right? Not bad for leasing. I mean, how many of you would pay $21 per gig? Like, if you just could walk up to me right now and say, Ben, I want to rent your machine for $21 today. I'm going to go make a buttload of money with it. Well, of course you would, right? I mean, who wouldn't do that? That'd be a smart move to be able to do that. Even if you did only 3 pig gigs though monthly, let's take this down from, you know, Jason's high number, and but the average, you know, we took the average, which gave us the 21, but let's take even lower than that. That was 12 gigs. Let's go to 3 gigs a month. You'd have a cost each gig of about $83.33 per gig. Would you rent a machine from me for $83.33 to go do a gig that you're going to make $500 or $600 on? That's like a no-brainer, right? If the average Roasting Nomad Tribe member makes $604 per gig, and they do, okay, then realistically, 1 gig a month will pay for your equipment lease and still leave you a healthy profit. That's $250 a month. Starts sounding a whole lot more good or better, right? It just is easier. So it just makes good sense. So I'm going to show you the difference between nothing versus something, okay? If you do nothing, nothing is easy, right? Nothing is just simple. I like doing nothing sometimes. It's just really easy. Another thing about nothing is the expenses. Well, they're nothing. Makes it even better, right? Nothing. And income. Here's the crappy part about doing nothing. Your income doesn't change. Your freedom doesn't change. Nothing changes, and you get nothing. So with nothing, you get nothing. And on the other hand, something is mo good or better, okay? And it should be obvious to you by now, or you wouldn't be an entrepreneur. You wouldn't even be considering this if you weren't looking to do something, because you cannot move ahead in life. You cannot gain the things you want or the freedom you want and the freedom you deserve without moving ahead. If you stay stagnant, you're just going to grow mold like a tree, okay? So here's the other thing. With something, you have an expense, but that expense equals an investment. And what does an investment equal? An investment equals profit and freedom. So the bottom line, you can do nothing and nothing will change. You can do something and everything changes, okay? Everything. Now, let's take, if I'm glad my Dunkin' Donuts down the road and somebody took a huge something, they did a huge something and spent probably $500,000 to $1 million to put in and to buy the franchise of Dunkin' Donuts. And now I get to go down there and have delicious coffee and the occasional cream-filled donut. But their payoff for that is somewhere around 5 to 10 years. 5 to 10 years just to break even. To break even, right? So the Pig Roaster Pro, though, let's take this number. Let's take the $12,000, okay, that you had to pay over the whole term of the lease. I'm not saying you couldn't pay it off quicker. You could, okay? You can pay it off way quicker. But I want to give you the math here. $12,000 divided by 604 average profit per gig. 20 pig gigs is all it'd take. 20 pig gigs, and you've paid it off. Now, I'm not asking you or telling anybody to take 100% of their profit and pay it towards their lease or their finance deal so that they're all out of debt, right? Because it's really not a debt if you're using it as a write-off as well. It's actually an income, okay? Your debt is an income at that point. So you still get to make a great income while every payment is being made and then enjoy a 100% tax write-off for all those payments. So what does this really cost you? What does it really cost? Nothing. Nada. Zip. Zilch. There's no cost, right? And you're going, well, Ben, you still got to finance. But I just explained that to you. I just explained, I could go right now, buy me a new boat. I'm going to finance it. That boat's not going to make me anything, right? It's an expense. I can go buy a new grill or a new anything for my house, a new motorcycle. Expense. Has no value and less value than when I bought it. Where with something that's going to change your life, make you money, and put you ahead, there it's a no-brainer. There's no expense. It's an investment which turns into profit, which has a zero cost, which means it's a 100% profitable investment. So I don't see how anyone could do any different. If you have any questions about it, though, I want you to feel free to call me, okay? Call me, and let's talk about it. and I'll answer any questions I can on it. Now, I'm not a finance guru, but I understand investing. I understand investing, taking this money and turning it into this money. And that's what I wanted to share with you today. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you'll join the Roasting Nomad Tribe. I hope you, if you've already been approved or you're waiting on an approval and you get the approval and you go, oh my gosh, this is going to cost, I'm going to be paying like $9 million by the time it's done. Nope. It's zero cost. It's zero cost. Ultimately, it's a zero cost. You could do one job a month and it already paid for itself, and that one job still makes you a profit. Because your one job's going to net you, based on our averages already, it's going to net you more than the payment. So I can't even imagine why this wouldn't make sense for anyone, for you especially. I know that it would. Okay, so I may be preaching to the choir here, but I wanted to explain it and put it into, sometimes we get overwhelmed. We go, oh my gosh, that's going to be $250 a month. I can't do it. That $250 is going to make you thousands. Thousands. So, hope y'all come back and see us and join the Roasting Nomad Tribe.